Hi guys, it's Sherry. I hope that you're having a wonderful day. Let's make some skinnies. Y'all stay tuned. So yesterday you saw me make these gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous writing tablets using one of these from the Dollar Tree. So today I am going to show you how to take the same notepad and get four, you heard me, four of these beautiful skinny notepads. Absolutely gorgeous. When you open them up, oh my goodness, look how cute that is. Don't you just love that snowman? I think I'm gonna call him Sal the Snowman. He's so cute. And how are we going to do this? Well, I am about to show you. So we're gonna start with this writing tablet and we're gonna open it up and I'm just gonna guesstimate halfway. So we're gonna spread it out just like this. And for me, I am going to use my finger blade. If you have an X-Acto knife, that works too. But we're just gonna cut straight down the middle until we have this nice and released. And then I'm just gonna clean this up just a little bit, get rid of some of this roughage. The first thing that I'm going to do is to decide where I need to make my marks. And if you buy these pads, you need to make your marks at 2 7/8. So if you get these writing tablets from the Dollar Tree, your mark is going to be made at 2 7/8. So all I'm doing is coming from the top to the bottom, just giving myself some guides on where I'm gonna start making my cuts. And you guys have seen me do this before, but I wanted to do it again so that I could show you how we can get four pads from one. And all I'm gonna do is place my ruler on my marks, and then I'm just gonna bring in my blade and let my blade roll against the ruler so that I can get a straight edge cut. And just like that, we've got two skinnies. And when you do it with the other piece, you end up with four skinnies. So I am going to take off the top piece because I do have marks on those possibly. So we've got two skinnies, and now we are going to take one of them and turn them into a really cute notebook. So I have this wonderful Christmas paper. And the piece that I'm working with measures 4 by 12. I don't need the full 12, but I didn't cut it down any smaller. So I'm gonna place a piece of chipboard down, and this chipboard is the exact measurement of this. So the length of this is 8 3/4, and then 2 7/8. So my chipboard measures 2 7/8 by 8 3/4. So I'm gonna come back in with my scissors and then I'm gonna fold this over and then I'll come back and I am going to miter cut my edges. So I'm gonna place down my tape, and this is my 1 inch tape, and I only need to place it in 2 spots, and then I'm gonna lift it up. And then I'll fold over my paper, just like this. And there, we've got one part of our cover done. So I have a piece here that measures 2¾ by 8½. And this will be the piece that I'm going to lay down as my liner. So I'm going to take a piece of my tape, place it right in there for my liner, lift that up, and then I'll come back with my glue. And a lot of you had questions about the smaller bottle that I'm using. These are actually bottles that I've had, my own personal bottles, and I just fill them with my reptile glue. And then I'm just going to place this down just like that. And I'll come back with my paper towel, and we're going to get everything stuck down. So I'll come over it with my bone folder, get that nice and stuck. And just like that, we have got a nice piece to our book. So I'm going to bring in my other piece of paper. I won't have you guys watch me do this because you just saw me do it. And I'm going to go through the same process that I just went through to make this one. So this one also measures 2⅞ by 8¾. So I'll be right back. All right, guys. So my boards are done, and now we're ready to place our skinny pad. And the way that we do that is I am going to take my pad and place some glue on it, and then I'll lay it down on my board. So all I'm going to do is take my pad, glue up a back sheet, and then I'll place it down on my board, and I'm going to make sure that I get everything nice and flush at the top. And then once I've gotten it nice and flush at the top, I'll run my fingers along just to make sure it feels good. And then I'm going to come back with my top piece, and I am going to take it and stand everything up to make sure I've got it nice and straight. So then when I've got it straight and I'm satisfied with how it looks, I'm going to take a piece of my 1-inch tape and I'm going to place some on the front. I'll go all the way to the back and just get that stuck down just like this. Okay, guys, so then what I'm going to do is I am going to take a piece that measures 2⅞ by 2⅞, and I have put tape on the back, and that is going to be the piece that I place up top. So the first thing I'll do is I will remove the backer sheet from my tape, but I'm going to leave my tape down, and then I'll bring in this piece, and where you place it is truly up to you. So I'm going to bring it down about this much, get it down, and then I'll just fold it across the top, come back with my bone folder. I'm going to get that fold nice and crisp, and then I'll bring it to the back, and I'm going to fold it over just like that, and I'll come to the back and get that nice and crisp, and then I'll come back to the front. And just like that, you can already see the cuteness. So then I have my beautiful, beautiful Anna Griffin bows. And I am going to take one, put some glue on the back, and I'm going to stick this bow right there. And then I have this beautiful Santa that's also from Anna Griffin. And I'm going to take him and tuck him underneath. And I'll use the little pom-pom in his hat as my guide. So I'm just going to put him down just like that. Isn't he cute? And then I'm going to place 3 dots of glue right here at the bottom, because I am going to place some flat-back pearls. So I'll place my center one first, come back with my other one. And guys, you don't have to do this. I just like to put down some of these pearls every now and then. And then I'm going to straighten these out. And I think that looks so good. So, as you can see, we have made this wonderful, wonderful skinny notepad using one of the Dollar Tree writing tablets that we cut down, cut it into fours, and now we're able to get four super cute notebooks out of one pad, people. Four. Isn't that just amazing? We can get four. What a value for your buck. So you change the papers on this, and you can make this for any season, any reason, any gender. Everybody loves making lists, taking notes, and at Christmas time, these are great ways to actually make your Santa's list. And I want to give a shout out to Barbara Shipley because she suggested making these and using belly bands. And I think that is a fantastic idea to use belly bands to make a Santa's list notepad. Wonderful idea. So Barbara, thank you so much. And guys, wouldn't this look cute with some belly bands? I think they would. So I hope you guys have liked this project. And if you have, please hit the like button. If you are not a subscriber to my channel, I would love to have you join my online crafting family. As you guys can see, not only do we create, but we innovate on this channel. So, y'all have a great day. Happy crafting, and we'll chat later. Bye.